Welcome.
I think we're live. Forgive the delay. I had to make sure the patch bay was set up properly. And it is set up properly. So if you're not in the know and you're not part of our Discord, we just released the pack called the Analog Pack. So all you have to do is join us in Discord. I'll leave a link in the YouTube chat. This is for all the people watching the replay. BusyWorksBeats.com/Discord. Click here to download the Analog Pack. So basically, because we've hit 10,000 folks in the new Discord, we decided to do a pack, or release a pack, I should say. Okay, the pack's called the Analog Pack. You're going to get 73 drum kits. Some are vintage, some are modern. You're going to get 30 presets for Serum specifically, 47 unique one-shots, and then 60 MIDI things for you. And there's the link in the page right there. So come join us in Discord. We've also introduced teams on the Discord. So you have to join the Discord to be a part of the teams. Teams is more than beat battles, but we're gonna start off the teams in the beat battles. So if basically the teams right now are, let's see the teams. And we have team leaders too. So we have the teams are Oddball, which is basically the red team. The blue team is called Aftermath. The yellow team is called Golden Suns. And then the green team is called the Headshot Killers. So who runs the green team is Ricey. If you're familiar with our Discord, Ricey runs. He's the leader of this along with Relo. And I want to say Marty Minning is another top dog from our Beat Battle League. They're top dogs. Top dogs are some of the world's best beat battlers on the planet. Nafi Beats, what's up? What team is Nafi on? Nafi's on Aftermath. He decided on the name. The blue team is led by Nafi Beats. And I think Jubbs Beats is also in here. And they collabed, ironically. So there we go. And they're representing the blue team, and they just put out a Nipsey track. So you put the do the math. Okay, do the aftermath, I should say. The yellow team is run by, it's called the Golden Suns, and it's run by Beats by Ree, I want to say. Wait, I'm forgetting the whole leadership. Give me a second. Let's figure out who runs the yellow team. Yeah, Beats by Ree and Judo are new contender in the Beat Battle League. And then the greens, I said the green team already. And the red team is run by DJ Rob Snow and 85 Savage right now, okay? Who are also top dogs. So that's the structure. So come join us on Discord, pick a side, any side. Now once you pick a side, you gotta be loyal to that side. Okay, so these teams, if once you join a team, you'll have a special icon next to your name. So if you go to the main chat, you can see who actually has joined a team. If you hover over this little icon, it'll say their team name. So Exelton is on the Oddball team. Crank has a different icon. He's on the Headshot Killers. Mr. Kamar J is on Aftermath. And then let me see if I can find a sun emoji in here. Give me a second to look. I'll just go to their team. Okay, and then the Golden Suns have this little sun. I can't zoom in on YouTube, but there's a little golden sun right there. Okay, so we're gonna have fun. We got teams going. This is becoming a huge thing. So I wanted to thank you guys for helping us create a producer city, basically, of over 10,000 folks. And we're just getting started. This is the very, 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 very beginning of all this. But I wanted to make it more fun and have teams. And the only way to get into certain challenges is to be on a team. So the benefit for being on the teams, I put it in the thing here, I believe. So each team has a leader, which will guide the teams. Teams can collab, share secrets, and live stream, which we're going to bring soon once we get enough team members on each team. And the members of each team will be eligible to enter future challenges and be eligible to receive airdrops. And airdrops are basically, if your team wins a challenge, like if anybody on your team wins a challenge, your whole team gets a reward called an airdrop. Okay. And teams will, team members will gain skills faster, be able to collab easier, and earn exclusive team rewards and battle for a chance to win more rewards. So that's what we've got going on so far in the Discord. So I want to thank everybody for hopping in. Let me say my hellos on YouTube and we can get this whole thing rocking. So today we're going to focus on the analog sounds in celebration of the new achievement you guys have unlocked, which is having 10,000 members, and you've unlocked the analog achievement. The analog pack achievement. Give me one sec. Gotta do some business real quick. So that's what we're going to be getting into today is analog stuff. Sorry, people don't know I'm live and they just start messaging business stuff because they don't know. Okay, so what we're going to get into is, so let's see who's here first. Turtle Speed, and you can only comment on YouTube if you're a subscriber, if you're wondering why you can't comment. Turtle Speed, welcome. Official Man Killer is here. He put a whole bunch of jarble. Shout out to you. Mad Hatter just downloaded the analog pack. Thank you, Mad Hatter. And it's going to expand. That's just one achievement of many to come. We've just unlocked teams. Gilly Gill says, yeah, he made it. I think I saw you commenting in the live about something, but I couldn't read it. It was too long to read. I saw you said something about the battle. Thank you for hopping in with us. Nali Poo, hello. Nafi's here. Sensei Quran, what's up? Let me just reply because this is like big business. Hold on. Just gotta click on a link. Give me a second, y'all. Gotta do work. Okay, cool. All right, and then this thing, give me a second. Too many, there we go. Okay, phone on silent, there we go. So Lewis is here. We got Lotus is in the building. Let's go Aftermath. So it's funny enough, it just worked out perfectly. Like the emojis worked out perfectly. I was like, this can't be real. So Aftermath, since it was the blue team, I was looking for blue emojis. And then the ATM emoji popped up on the thing, and it just so happened to be blue. And not only is the ATM icon blue, it spells Aftermath, ATM. Like, what are the odds of that? That's not a coincidence. So the blue team emoji is gonna be, let me find it on my slide bar real quick. I don't know where it's at on the, I gotta slide through all these emojis. So the blue team is Aftermath, and then you guys can rep every live stream. And the key is basically that you're basically your own companies. That's basically what you are. You're your own record labels. So you got Aftermath, you got the sun emoji. This is the Golden Suns. You got, who else is in here? Oddball, which is a red circle. Let me see if I can find it. This is Oddball, which is the red team. And then you got the headshot killers. I didn't want to put the skull because it was too death related. So I put a little green team, the green tongue emoji with the money on it. And it's a head emoji. So I figured it would make sense. So let me find it on my scroll bar real quick. Where's it at? Here it is. And then the headshot killers. Okay, so those are the team emojis. So we're going to be going live and reminding people of their team emoji. How does one join the team? Good question. Once you join our Discord, make sure that you verify that you're human. You got to go to the rules. I think there's something else. There's like something else you have to click on. But if you go to the rules, you should be able to see how to verify yourself or something. There's like a verification step. I want to say it's either in the IMA or it's in the rules tab. So once you click in, you click the rules in the IMA, and then you confirm that you're a human. And once you confirm that you're a human, you'll see all this other stuff. So if you don't see all this other stuff, it's because you didn't verify that you're a human yet. Now under, if you scroll all the way to the bottom, you'll see where it says beat battles. Sometimes you may have to unnest things. Okay, go to beat, actually don't go to beat battles, I'm wrong. Right where it says welcome and roles, click where it says the colors and then choose a team. And then up, scroll to the, let me just start over because I just realized I screwed everybody up. Okay, so once you go to busyworksbeats.com/discord, then you want to make sure that you're a human. Click on the rules tab. I think there's like another dialogue that pops up under the rules tab. Okay. Click IMA to let us know who you are. That's just another tag for different reasons. And then click on where it says these colors, choose a team. And then you want to scroll to the top and you click on one of these little boxes to choose a team. Okay. So once you click red, you're red. Once you click yellow, you're yellow. Once you click green, you're green. Once you click blue, you're blue. Dedicate yourself to a team. And then you'll see if you scroll down under where it says beat battles, you unnest these and then you'll see your team's private chat. I can see everything because I'm one of the, they're called presidential roles here. But under beat battles, you'll see your team's chat here. So this is a private chat. So only red team can see the red team's chat. Only blue team can see the blue team's chat. Only the yellow team can see the yellow team, and only the green team, the green team. And that's where you guys can share information, tips, whatever it is. We're gonna introduce live streaming. We're not there yet. We just gotta make sure people have joined their teams first. And then we'll do a live streaming to where you guys can live stream with only your team and you can collab live. Okay, so that's how you do it. I know that's a little convoluted for the people who aren't even used to Discord. So the first step is just join our Discord and just you'll get it over time because it took me a while to understand Discord. So just go to busyworksbeats.com/Discord and give me a sec, guys. I got to handle these replies real quick. Give me one sec. How do you spell? All right, I can't reply. I go back and forth. Okay, so onto the stream. We are back at it. So how many people are in here, first of all? Now, this is a legitimate big business. I got to pay attention. Okay, so we got a good amount of folks in here, so I can get started. So today we're going to focus on analog. So again, you're going to get a free analog pack. The community has unlocked the achievement. After 10,000 members, you've unlocked an airdrop pack called the analog pack, and you can get it for free once you join our Discord. And then once you join the Discord, scroll down to where it says news and downloads, and then click where it says free downloads. And that's how you access your free downloads. If you're new, I'll put it in the other chat just in case. If you're new, click here to access the analog pack. Hashtag free download. So once you click on the little hashtag, you'll be directed over there. Okay, so that's that. I don't think I need Discord open. Might eat up a little CPU. Hold on, y'all. Okay, cool. You guys ready? Give me a thumbs up. Give me some kind of reaction if you're ready to rock. So we're gonna focus on analog synths today. Analog synths, let me give you a little back history. So if you want like one place to get started, Arturia is a great place because it's a niche sound and they've mastered the niche of analog recreations. So if you go to Analog Lab, or it's called Arturia's Analog Connection, thank you, Nafi, collection, I mean to say, you'll find these synthesizers. So they're spread out. There's not one plugin you load up except Analog Lab, but I'm not going to show you that because actually I think it has a visual to it. I will show you that. Thank you, Lotus. Appreciate you spending your quality time with me. So again, we're going to make tracks using analog stuff. Now, the reason I'm using software is because I can use my keyboards and stuff behind me, but you can't see it, so it's pointless. There's no point in me making a beat over there when you're watching the screen and just looking at sound waves. It's not very visually pleasing. They used to have it to where you could see a room full of synths, but I don't know where that's at. So let me just describe each synth real quick. Baby Guitars is ready to go. Jeff's here, what's up? Leroy's came through, I didn't even notice. What's up? Midnight Void is here, Blue Team. Noodles is here, what's up? Suva Threed, I'm probably saying that wrong. Welcome. Dion Isaiah is here. Chromie's here. Just notice, I always had an issue you recording the notes. I can record the track. How do I record MIDI? You record up here. Hit notes and automation. I'm assuming that's what you're talking about. I'm not sure your question is worded really weirdly. Definitely join in one later. Any needed skill levels? You can join the teams regardless of your skill level. That's how you're gonna level up faster, is joining a team. The teams, hopefully I describe what the teams are for. But yeah, the teams have a lot of benefits. Start talking analog. Okay, so the reason again I chose to use Arteria today is because it's just visual. You can copy everything we're showing you here on real stuff and it's the same exact thing. Okay, so the ARP 2600 is more for, like it says, arpeggiating stuff. It's very complex and it uses semi-modular functions, I believe. The B3 is, I think, an organ. I'm gonna just highlight the stuff that matters, stuff that we use in hip hop. CMI is like, I think they use that on Thriller, something like that. Analog Lab is where they, it's like their Omnisphere. It's like Arteria's Omnisphere, but only analog stuff. Okay, so you have the CS80. This is my best friend Jacob's favorite one he put me on. A little hard to hear this. So this one comes with a lot of quirky sounds. Not the easiest to program though. So for example, here's the interface. This is not, even for me, who sound design, it's not that easy. No, it's my voice, it's super dry, I don't know why. I just brush my teeth, I think sometimes. Oh, you know what it was? It was the rinse I put in my mouth. Cause my, I was like, damn, my throat is super dry. You're right. Thank you for reminding me. Okay, because I'm trying to skip over details too, so not focus on too much stuff. So this is the CS80, and it has a lot of quirky sounds. Now these are pretty normal, but you can't even hear this one. Hold on, these sounds are super low. Let me crank these up. Give me a second, yo. Just gotta crank these up. There we go. Of course, when I hit all the notes, it gets super loud. MD's here, what's up? Okay, so analog, if I had to describe it, the real thing, when you play the real thing versus like a synthesizer, and I'm not doing this to throw shade or anything. I just want y'all to understand what I'm talking about. So there's a plugin called Flex by Image Line. This is mostly digital stuff from what I understand. And you'll notice it has like a bitey sound to it. Very clean type of sound. So I'm just gonna click on random presets. Very bitey or very clean. Okay, so that's digital. Now analog, now I'm not sure they sampled everything from this, but analog just has a different depth of sound, in my opinion. CS80 is known for the Blade Runner. Oh, I didn't know that. Do you usually make beats with monitors or headphones? Headphones, because monitors, I have to keep turning my mic down and it gets annoying. So I do it over headphones mostly now. What's up, Robert? Thank you. I just saw that. Soothing ambient sounds, says DJ380. I'm not sure what that is, but it sounds like a piece of gear. Just notices I can record my analog melodies, but can't track each note I played. Oh, you're gonna need a MIDI out if you wanna capture your notes. You have to have a MIDI out. So if you're playing your actual analog synth by hand and you're trying to capture the notes, you need to plug up a MIDI out into what's called a MIDI interface and then plug your MIDI interface into your computer. And that's how you record the notes. And then you would tell your, in FL Studio, you would use the plugin called MIDI out. And then you would set the input right here, the port channel, that's the out port. Actually, this is out. I don't know about MIDI in. I guess you would just record. Yeah, how would that plug up to the computer? You would go into your options, go to MIDI, and then your input MIDI would be down here. And you would set the port here. And then you would use that to control whatever plugin. So you go to your plugin, go to the settings, and you have an input port here. So that when you're playing on your whatever keyboard, it will input the MIDI signal from the keyboard over into whatever plugin that you want. And that's how you can record the MIDI notes. Okay, thanks for clarifying. I wasn't sure what you were saying before. So I'll be doing some of that today. I'll be using my actual keyboard, so I have to use what's called MIDI out. So the computer is sending electricity to the keyboard. The keyboard reads the electricity and gives back electricity called sound. Hold on one sec, I gotta schedule something. All right, one sec. So, hold up. All right, had to set up a meeting. Give me 3 seconds. Boom. Okay, I cannot be interrupted anymore. So let's keep this thing rocking. Physical synths come with natural harmonics and a pop in the mix. Yeah, physical synths, it's so hard to explain unless you hear it. So what I'm gonna do is just, I'm gonna play with the software synths, and also the physical stuff, you have knobs and stuff you can turn as you're doing stuff. With software, you're not turning knobs when you're playing the MIDI. Most people aren't assigning knobs to the MIDI controller. They're not doing that. So that's another advantage that you have over having the real thing. Plus the real thing just sounds better. Even this sample stuff doesn't really sound superior to the real thing, in my opinion. Because it's almost, there's only so much quality that they can capture in a sample of this size. Because they had, never mind, I'm getting too geeky with it. But basically this plugin is not a gazillion gigabytes. But if they had a lot more space, it would have a higher quality. But it does have a good quality. I'm not gonna say it's terrible. Okay, so analog is a different sound. The main thing that people like about analog is the instability. It's unpredictable in certain ways, whereas digital is very harsh to the ear, some would say, and it's very predictable. There are ways to make digital stuff sound analog, but when you hear like a real analog synth that has sounds in it, you're like, I've never heard of anything like this before. That's when you're gonna understand analog. Okay, so I think we have explained analog enough. Let's get this thing rocking. We got a lot of people to entertain. So let's make an actual track using analog. The key analog synths you guys wanna look for, let's go back, are gonna be CS80 is cool. The DX7 is good for like e-piano type stuff, R&B. We got the, where's it at? On my screen. Glitching. We got the Juno 6. They renamed it June 6, but the Juno 6, or Juno, what is it? Now I'm thinking, because they changed the name. Now I'm like, what's the original name? It's the Juno 6, and then there's a 106. So that's confusing. Then you got the Jupiter 8, which people know. And then you got the Moog stuff, so the Mini Moog. So the Mini Moog is like the Mike Dean synth, basically. And then that's it. Oh, and then where's the Prophet? Yeah. Oh, okay. I didn't realize there was more. Then you have the OBX is known for like its brassier tone. So let's open this up. Oh, I don't have this. You need to own the full version of da, 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 blah, blah, blah. Never mind. So I don't have the full version of it, but that's known for like its brassy tone. And then you have the Prophet 5 and the Prophet 6 are just, I don't know how to explain their tone, but it's more of like a, I think Thriller, I mean, what's that show called? Not Thriller, Stranger Things. So think of the Prophet like a Stranger Things type synth. Juno 6 and 60 and 106. Yeah, there's so many freaking Junos. I'm like, why would y'all use the same number? That's terrible marketing. Okay, so here, I mean, I'm playing really softly, but let me crank it up a little bit. Think Stranger Things. Okay, so you get that kind of, it's when you program the Prophets, they're more like saw-based sounds. You can get pulse waves from it, but it's more so triangle, saw wave, square sound. Larry G's here, what's up? Who else is up in here? Brian's here, he made it. Fabian says, digital stresses me out when going through sounds. Oh, also, yeah, analog generally is like better presets too. Inferno's here. Just notice this, thanks. You're welcome. Okay, so those are all the synths. I don't wanna bore you guys to tears with education. Just wanna start making a track. Okay, so in real time, let's start using this stuff in real time. First, we're gonna start with something that's polyphonic. That's another thing about synths. Some are monophonic, some are polyphonic. Poly means many, and then Mano means one. Okay, so the Moog, for example, is a monophonic. One of the, I can't say all of them are monophonic because they're not all monophonic. The Moog one that just came out is polyphonic, but so much to explain to y'all. The Moog sound, it gives you like a creamy sound. So it's the hip hop bass. So if it's not an 808, it's probably a Moog that's creating the bass line. The Phil Collins tone, you guys know more history than me. I don't know every, Prophet 5 is John Carpenter pads. All right, shout out to John Carpenter. Jupiter is my favorite. I don't like the Jupiter. For some reason, it just sounds kind of whatever to me. Also, you have the Roland plugin. There's so much to go through. So that's why I said I got to go through this one by one. So let's make a track. Let's put this stuff to use. So first, we're going to start with the Prophet from Arteria. Okay, we're going to say no. And you want to go through presets because setting this thing up could take a little bit of time. So let's go to keys to get a basic starter sound. This also has like this mod thing over it called a vector synth, which is a whole different thing. So again, we're just looking for a quirky sound we can play chords with. Let's make an R&B track. Here's another thing I forgot to say. In the new Discord, I'm going to challenge you guys. We're going to make a track for Keyshawn. So if you guys know Keyshawn from all the live streams that we've been in, we're going to challenge the community to make a track for Keyshawn. And basically, how this all pans out is whoever makes the best track that Keyshawn actually picks, then we're going to spread the multi-tracks with everybody in the community, whether it's the vocal, the beat breakdown, whatever it is. We're going to spread it to the entire community. We're all going to have open source. This is basically going to make an open source album. Okay, so everybody has access to the project file, the multi-tracks, I can say, the project file for the mixing, the recording, raw vocals without auto-tune and crap on it, and then we're going to share with everybody so that everybody can have a chance to make a remix as well. So you have the original producer who's going to be producing for Keyshawn, we're going to have the remixes, and then we're all going to be a part of this whole thing. So everybody wins, and we're going to be pushing our own artists from now on. Think of it like a community record label, in a sense. We're going to be pushing our own stuff. So it's going to be fun. I think it's going to challenge you guys to actually make music for people instead of just making random beats, which some people like making random beats. Some people like producing for people. So this will challenge you guys. So I have a couple artists lined up for the collab challenges, but you have to be a part of the Discord and you have to be a part of the teams. So if you are new here, you got to go to busyworksbeats.com/Discord to join us. So if you want to be a part of these opportunities, the record label, so to speak, you got to join our Discord and you have to join a team. So click here to join our Discord.
Spell it right.
Okay, so the only way you can submit is going to be through those team areas. And the only way to access the team areas is if you're a part of a team. Okay, so hopefully that makes sense. A DeepMind 12, yeah, that's a good emulation, I've heard. Can we get an advance? I think we got to realize the bigger picture, because if Timbaland brought up Aaliyah, if R. Kelly brought up an Aaliyah, that's the mindset I want to put into you guys, not just chasing artists down all the time. Everybody's chasing Drake. Drake is not worried about 99.999999% of y'all. The odds of getting a Drake placement are very slim. Make your own artist, build your own infrastructure. So that's what I'm going to show you how to do. Okay, so I don't want to eat up too much time talking about that, but that's what we're going to make today, is a Keyshawn track. Now, he gave me reference tracks, but I don't think we can play them on YouTube because, let me see what he says. Nikki Indigo. I don't know who this is. So let's look it up. He gave me a reference track. So the first thing you do with an artist is you ask them to send you reference tracks, because you don't want to just blindly make stuff and then they don't like it, because you'll be just wasting your time. So this is called Nikki Indigo. This is one of his reference tracks. This looks like a huge track. So what I'm going to do is mute the mic real quick. I'm going to play a little bit of it and then get an idea of what's in the track. So I have to mute my mic real quick. Nikki Indigo. Give me a second, y'all. Now, if this is too much, I'll tell you in 3 seconds. Just give me a sec. All right, sounds very K-pop. So what it is to me is you have a bell melody. So here's the first thing I do when I'm reverse engineering. You listen to the song and you map out everything that's in it. So it has very short, sharp chords. They're lush chords, so let's say lush, short chords. It has bells in it and has like a bass that moves. It's not necessarily an 808, but it's like a moving bass. Sounds like an 808-ish kind of bass. Those are our main ingredients. And then it's modern drums, like trap drums. So that's the record from what I heard. I didn't figure out the key. I would take more time to figure out the key, but we don't, I don't wanna have y'all listening to nothing for forever. Okay, so that's the Nicki Indigo record. So the first thing is figuring out what kind of chord types. And once you get into, I'm trying to realize, what did I have here before? I had Discord. Wait, I'm missing an app. One of my apps disappeared off my thing. I don't remember what was there. Oh, it was the health app. There we go. Okay. Hold on, y'all. Apple decided to rearrange my screen. It's not what I wanted. There we go. Okay. Micro, you have a Micro Brute, a Micro Freak, and a Crave, and a Refaced CS. You're in deep. Is Ozone 9 worth it? The Elements? I recommended the whole bundle, not the Elements. You need the dynamic EQ, you need their compressor, and you need their limiter. Anything else, it's kind of irrelevant. Yeah, true, there's like a chip shortage. Okay, so it sounded like Prophet chords. Now, once you get into sound design, or music theory, I should say, you'll realize that certain types of chords sound better regardless of the key. So for example, once you get into minor ninth chords, they only sound really good in like one octave, which is around the D minor area. And why does it sound so quiet? There we go. Okay, so the chords I heard were very short, so they don't have what's called a long release tail. So we're gonna lower the release tail of this synth. I like Oberheim's for the brassy tone. I like the, I think it was an OBX I played in real life. It was the craziest tone I've ever heard in my entire life. I don't know if it was musical, but it was intense. It was very intense. So we want short chords using this sound. Okay, but we're gonna make like minor ninth chords, but we're not gonna voice it that way. We're gonna spread out the notes so they're not so dense. First thing we're gonna do is either raise the third, or we're gonna lower. So let me show you the notes because this ain't making sense. If y'all don't see it, let's right click, go to piano roll. So let's start with something as simple as a D minor 9, which is D, F, A, C, E. It's a D minor 9 chord. It's basically five notes that make a nice chord. So if you're going jazzy and lush chords, you wanna think of four note chords or more. That's what's gonna give you that lush sound. Are you referring to the D2, D3 thing? I don't know what that is. Plus, you gotta think, if it costs $5,000 to get a real synth, who in the world is spending 5 G's? Hold on, y'all, I gotta communicate real quick with this team. Hold on 1 second. Why is it not showing up? It just showed me a message. Oh, where is it? What? Well, they must have, I don't know what happened. Whatever, I don't know what happened. Wait, hold on. Hold up. Okay, I can't go back and forth, back and forth, and back and forth, and back and forth. All right, so we got the museum called SMIM. They got 1,000 synths in one room. 1,000 in one room? That's a lot of electricity. OB8, Prophet 5, SH1, and a very cool CS50. And you guys are in it. The note range C, da 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 da. In FL, it's a little bit different. Their notes are like off by an octave or two. I don't know who did the system, but it's off. A grandmother worth it, but the entire V collection is 270. Yeah, so price is a real thing. Okay, so I don't want to dive into the conversation here. So the D, F, A, C, E, but what we're going to do is move notes around. So we're going to transpose, it's called. We're going to pull this F down an octave. And let's pull this. We're going to But extend this just so we can hear it. Junior's here. What's up? Hey, thank you, Junior. Appreciate you, Junior. Junior? Change my snap degree. So this is pretty dark because we have so many low frequencies. Okay, what else we could do? So we've lowered the third. You could also raise the third, but once you get into like the ninths, raising the third makes it 2/10 around that seventh. So you would probably have to raise the third and the seventh, which makes this a crazy voicing. But I mean, that's more EDM to me. Yeah, I did a video on the Black Friday deals. You should probably go watch that. If you want more details, in my opinion, I made a whole video about the Black Friday deals. And I explained the plugins that I recommend from iZotope. There was only like three out of the whole bundle. Okay, so you could also raise your third and your fifth. So let's get a little complex. Let's go minor 11. And then we're gonna lower the 11th down to condense the chord. I call this chord condensation. Condensing. This sound is just so muddy that when you go too low of a frequency, it gets too muddy. Why is my screen? Give me a second, y'all. I need to figure out how to make my screen normal again on this piano roll. Okay, so again, the chord. So let's follow the Keyshawn formula. Again, you have to join our Discord to even enter to submit for the Keyshawn thing. I have more instructions later, but that's what we're doing right now. We're making a track for Keyshawn using the references he gave me. So he gave me a reference of the track was called Indigo by, wait, it was called something. Nikki Indigo. Okay, which is like, it sounded like K-pop to me, which K-pop uses a lot of jazzy chords. And then they like make it modern sounding using the drums. So this sound is just too dark to begin with. So let's open up this cutoff filter, add a little resonance, and then we can fix the sound later with the filter. But let's work on the actual chords. Okay, let's take this ninth. What else did we transpose? I forgot what we did. Also, I don't like the pulse wave bass. I like the sawtooth bass. If you want a smooth sound, you go with the triangle. So the Prophet 5 has its limitations, I'll say. So DFACE, that's the normal voicing. Now let's get into a little more complexity. Again, pull the third down. I know it took 10 minutes to get here. But that's the formula. We're gonna pull that third down. Okay, so that's the key. So it's bent. And now my ear, what I'm listening for now is, what does the top note play? Dun, dun. So that's what I'm listening to. Hit shift to copy the chord. Then just ask yourself, does it sound like the right chord? If it doesn't sound like the right chord, you convert a major to a minor, and vice versa, convert a minor to a major chord. Okay, leave some space. Then I want G to be the top note. Now to me, this sounds wrong, quote unquote, but that's the cool part about ninth chords. Even if it's technically wrong, it can still sound good. So we're gonna make this a major by pulling up the minor third and the seventh, pull that up one, hit shift up. Could you do a video on synths and popular music, like old R&B songs we know? If more people ask, a lot of people don't ask for old R&B. They just don't like it. In popular music, sure. We'll focus on synths more. Yeah, that's what I do. Invert the notes, transpose the notes. Okay, so we're gonna take this, it just sounds wrong, quote unquote. We're gonna take the third and the seventh, pull it up one. So now these are the quote unquote proper chords. Yeah, whereas it's just not the expected chord, I'll say it that way. Or actually I'm telling my brain, that's not the chord I want in my brain. So that's what I mean by wrong. The Mellotron's another good one that I forgot to mention. Okay, so now we have that sound. We need to make this more full because right now it's very thin. So open up the cutoff filter to add more harmonic. Then use the envelope to shape it. We're getting a little advanced, but let's give it a curvature. So I'm gonna lower the cutoff. And this will dictate how the filter moves. So it's arrow. And that creates that 90s sound. It still sounds quiet even though it's very loud technically in dB. It's because these are lower frequencies and lower frequencies are harder to hear. Now we have our chords. Let's go to the next step, which were the bells. So we're gonna balance out those lower chords that don't have a lot of harmonic activity with some bells. So the question is, where do you go for bells? The DX7 is good because it's based in FM synthesis, which is good for bell sound design. Jupiter sounds, you should Super 6. Y'all are really getting deep. Plug and B. Heard of that before? I don't know what plug beats are still to this day. I have no idea. Jazz chords sound better inverted. True. For me, I agree. Thank you. Hey, thank you, Cam. Cam says, thank you for all your help, man. Been watching your vids for a while and helped me understand more about music production. Thank you. Okay, so now we need to get into the sound design. I'm gonna move a little bit quick here because it is very advanced. So the DX7 is an algorithm-based FM synthesizer. Okay, so these shapes here, you don't need to memorize what I'm saying right now. But basically the way these are formatted determines what controls what. So if I have operator 6 controlling operator 5, I can do cool things like, let me switch the algorithm here. If I have, what is this, 2 controlling 1, I could have 2 create upper harmonics by controlling 1. So for example, let's have 2 operator 2. These synths are super quiet, just give me a second. Okay, there we go. So right now I'm modulating what's called, let me turn off the other ones real quick. Give me a sec. So this is operator 1. It's simple. It sounds like a sine wave. Yeah, it's a sine wave. Very simple. But what happens is if I control operator 1 with operator 2, it starts to move it around and create what are called harmonics, different shapes of harmonics. Ultras from India, shout out to you. Yeah, Behringer, I hope they remake the PPG. That's one of my favorites. The free packs are in the Discord, so if you click the YouTube channel link, it'll get you there. So see how the difference? Before, I was just playing the notes. It's a sine wave, but now when I play the notes, it has this kind of tone to it. So that's called frequency modulation. It's called the ratio, the frequency ratio, basically the octave. So now I'm creating higher and higher harmonics. And that's how you start to get that bell sound. Okay, now you can raise the core frequency of operator 1. And now it's more in the bell range. So this is a little, I guess they have to copy the original format, but this screen is very hard to tell what is happening there. So let's go to envelopes, let's go to operator 1. And even still, this isn't the greatest like view of an envelope in my opinion, but we want to create a long release tail. So now when I hit, it says S here, this stands for sustain. I want to set it to where this final dot here is called a release tail. So when I hit a key and I let it go, it rings out. So now we have more metallic sounding sounds. So now I'm just gonna shape the actual sound. I know this looks complicated because it is. It's not easy to understand this screen right now. Okay, so that's what we're doing to create a bell type shape. And then we just need to make this longer. So that's how you make bells. Okay, we just need to make this envelope shorter because right now it's too long. This is like the worst thing. Hold up, y'all. I'm just trying to move the release tail and it's making me do a thousand things. So based on how long operator two lasts, it controls that shiny tone over operator one. Okay, so that's the sound. It could be a lot better if I spent time getting into it, but that's what we're looking for. That's why you would choose this, and that's why it's good for this type of sound. Now, I don't know if they have built-in bells. Hopefully they do, because that took a lot of time to sound design. Looks like they skipped straight over bells in here. Actually, let's search. It's another thing I like about Arturia stuff is you could search their presets. Okay, so let's see what we have so far. We just need a high-pitched bell. This is cool, but we want to take off that delay. Figure out how to do this. How do we get back to where we were? Let's go to the effects tab, take off the delay. Leroy's back. So even though this is pushing a lot of dB, this sound, it's not very full of a sound. I think I even made a bell in here. Let me see if I can find my bank. User bank. So I made some bells using this. We're trying to make a track for Keyshawn right now, if you're just hopping in, which is more R&B. I'm using the reference he gave me. Okay, so, I don't know, my soul isn't vibing with the DX7 bells, but that's where you would grab bells from if you're using analog stuff. I'm trying to think what other analog plugin would give us a good bell sound, let me think. Because of the FM functionality, that makes that super powered for that. We might just stick with that for now. We don't want to make this complicated. Okay, so now let's start getting into the rhythm. I didn't measure the BPM of that track either. So let me go back and listen to the BPM of the reference track. Okay, so we're at 145 BPM, and it seems like they played it like where it's regular time, but at a higher BPM. I'll show you what that means later. What's it called when you manipulate the effects on a sound automatically? Automation, is that what you mean? Like shifting a signal through a filter and having it going up and down automatically. This is called auto filter. I'm assuming that's what you're referring to. Filter sweep, maybe you're talking about a sweep. Okay, so let's start making this track. It's enough explaining, and I just want to show you guys what all this crap sounds like. So this is the analog. So if you just join in, you can get your free analog pack. Just go to our Discord, busyworksbeats.com/discord. The link's right in the YouTube chat. And then click on the free downloads tab once you get there. And that's, we're going to give you an analog pack. All the details are there. I can't play reference tracks on YouTube. They'll shut down the live. That's why I'm not playing it. Okay, so let's work on the drums because this needs more drums to understand what the heck is going on. Okay, so the drums were very like popish but trappish at the same time. So I'm going to go to Make Pop Music's library of drums because it's very fitting for this style. We're going to go to his Chart Toppers pack. We're going to go to the typical clap, which is, where is it at? Thought it was in here. Where's it at? I thought it was there. I'm thinking of a different pack. That's probably why my head. So I'm going to go to Essential 808s. Let's grab this. It's the Roland TR-808 clap. This is from a retro drum machine called the Roland TR-808, which is also a retro drum machine. We're going to add this in. And let's put the clap on the 3 and the 7. If you don't know what that is, turn on your metronome. Go to your pattern mode and count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3. Okay, so let's go to song mode. Add that in. So we're adding the modern sounds, and then we'll wrap around unique stuff around it. Thank you, Ed Jr. Okay, now let's add some like bouncier sounds around this. Let's go to make pop music. My throat was super dry from that rinse that I used. Give me a sec. It's like lingering. Okay, now let's go to the chart toppers and let's look for bouncy like sounds, like the snap, for example. Now, the biggest mistake I've seen people use is they use everything all at once. I'm gonna separate this into different patterns. So I'm gonna bring in the snap over time. I'm not gonna bring it in right away. It's gonna come in over time. Then we're gonna use this snare to build up speed. Hit Control L to send it to your mixer. I know I'm moving a little quicker here, but this is all theoretical stuff anyway. Okay, now let's go to pattern, what was it, 4? Add this in, and then we're gonna add a bouncy snare. So it's gonna boom, cat, 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 boom, tap, tap, tap. Any kind of bouncy you want. Let's turn the metronome on. If you can't count music, turn on your metronome. Okay, just adding that bounce. I'm gonna make this a little bit longer just so we could create variation here. It's another thing, people don't make their drums long enough. Oops, put that in the wrong spot. Tap, tap, Wrong spot. There we go. Okay, so I'm gonna work on this core sound because it's not very lush sounding. So one thing you could do is add coursing, then thicken out a sound. Spread it out. You can add a little attack to the envelope, filter envelope, to make it a little more brassy sounding. Now it's more R&B kind of. The resonance is the key for the R&B sound. And once you add resonance, it thins the sound down. We have a bunch of free sounds in the Discord. You just gotta look. There's a Metro Boomin drum kit in there. The official Metro Boomin drum kit. You gotta go to the free downloads tab. It's all there. Okay. Let's add some hi-hats. Now, I didn't really hear the hi-hats of the record, so I'm just kind of using whatever hi-hats I want. So again, remember, we're going off of a reference track. Now, it's very musical, the reference track, so we need to segment all this stuff and separate it into sections so that when we build the music around it, it builds up into some stuff. Once you join our Discord, you gotta go to the free downloads tab. So once you join Discord, click on the icon, scroll down to where it says news and downloads, and then look for free downloads, and the downloads will be right in there. You can even click this thing if you're in the Hive. It's right there. Sorry, I can't answer your question, Topsy, but when we're done, we will answer that. It's an R&B track from our guy Keyshawn. We're making a record for Keyshawn, and we're gonna challenge everybody on the teams, see who has the best record for Keyshawn. Turn the hi-hats down a little bit. So it sounds modern and trappy, but we're gonna build up into that. You're welcome. V-Nize is here, what's up? So the track seems super empty now because we don't have piano going. So we had lush short chords, that was part of the equation. What I'm gonna do is also show you how to layer. This used to be very common back in the day because their sounds weren't thick like our sounds are today. So I'm gonna layer another Prophet over top of the Prophet sounds we already have. R-Max says, don't think there's going to be a song feedback or beat. Why is that? I don't party, so I'm going to be live. Let's do this. I forgot it lands on a, what's tomorrow? Tomorrow is a Friday. Yeah, tomorrow's the 30th. Oh, tomorrow's New Year's Eve. Okay. I'll definitely be live. It's 9 p.m. anyway. So this, where is it at? It's fine. This has a pitch wobble effect on it. I'm trying to find out where they put it. Could be an LFO. I mean, let's use a better synth for this. Okay, so Prophet would be cool, but sometimes there sounds. Manchester Music, what up? Oh, is he here? Oh, shoot. There he is. Jeff Manchester. Long time, long see. I checked out your page like 2 weeks ago or something like that. I forget what you were talking about. You were talking about something. Let me look it up. Let me find Jeff Manchester. Let me find. Hold up. Let me show you what video I watched. It was. Oh, you have. Video. Okay, I didn't watch this one. Okay, it was a month ago. I'm wrong. It was Where Is Sound Toys. That's the video I watched. You can even see I'm proving it with the red bar, Jeff, that I watched this video. I need to make sure I'm getting notifications, because I don't think YouTube's sending out all the notifications to everybody. So y'all got to be careful with that. YouTube's not sending out all the notifications. Just letting y'all know. Shout out to Jeff. Jeff is that guy. So we got to find a sound to layer on top of this. These sounds aren't giving me the edge that I need. So I'm going to show you guys a secret plugin that I used yesterday to sound design. It's called Yuhi Diva. Wait, every team is doing a full song? Yes. It doesn't have to be a team song. It could be individual. But the thing is, you have to be on a team in order to submit. We're not going to just accept from anybody, because too many people in there. So Yuhi's Diva has a lot of cool stuff. If you go to presets, I'm going to use what's called a template, and I'm going to switch over to, I forget which one. I think it's called the Digi Yubi. This one has a crazy edgy sound. Keyflow knows. Keyflow was showing people how to use VSTs the other day. I saw your video. I didn't get to catch it live because I was doing something, but saw the title. Okay, so here's how it works. This Yuhi Diva thing. So this, I'm trying to keep this like basic but advanced at the same time. It's all based in harmonics, okay? So that's the easiest way to explain this. So I told you before the DX7 was known for its FM synthesis. This just gives you harmonics to work with. So let me see if I could turn off operator 2. I don't even know how to do that on the volume. Oh yeah, don't, never mind. So here's the first waveform. It's called a multi-saw waveform. This is called a tri-rap. I don't know what that means. Here's a noise waveform. Feedback. That's their pulse, which is extremely dense. For a pulse wave, that's really dense. You have another type of saw that you can bend around. Then you have their version of a triangle wave. So what we're going to do to thicken up the sound is use a multi-saw or something very harmonically rich like a pulse wave. So we're pretty low in the octave. Let's hit control up. Then turn it down a little bit. And then I'm going to start with the first sound. Let's do the pulse. This might not be. Let's change the pulse width. It's very stabby sounding. Not giving me the sound I wanted. But if you spike it up, I think this is either an EQ shift or a resonance point. Can't tell what it is. But I'm looking for tone. There we go. That's a nice tone. Now let's mix it. Let's go to the second sound. We're gonna use a multi-saw and detune it. Pull the detune amount in so it's not as lush and blurry of a sound. If we pull this to the right, gives you that EDM type sound. Okay, so now we have these two sounds. We're gonna combine them using the mix blend. Still a little dense to me. It feels too noisy. Let's pull up the octave. Sometimes the octave helps. So it still feels noisy to me, so we're gonna use a filter. We're going to use envelope 2 to control the filter. Add a little attack. Then we're going to add the chorus effect. So click here, go to chorus. Just pull it back to wet level. So I realize the chords get a little boring because they're repeating. So now let's go back and let's make these chords more exciting. Now that we have all this lined up. Let's pull this closer, hit Alt up. Then what you could do in FL, you can open up what's called a layer. So it makes it easier to do MIDI. You can open up a layer and then highlight the two tracks that you want to control. Go back to your thing and hit Set Children. And then now when you play with the layer tab, you control both the synths at one time. Let's open up the cutoff a little bit. Add a little release. So it's hard to hear the first synth because it's the harmonics aren't stretching all the way across. One sec. Hold on one sec. Where's the... Paper girl's funny. All right, my bad, y'all. So... Oh. All right, shout out to my baby girl, Nicole Nix. She's funny. All right, so back to the schedule programming. So you have, the trick here is that you're trying to hear both sounds, but they're one is outshining the other one because it's very noisy and harmonically rich, and then you have that subtle jazzy sound. So here's where you would use your level to dictate what's more important. I'll say more important, but what's prioritized. Again, this sound is so low, and I don't know why it's so low. Then you blend these two together as if it's like a seesaw. Now this has a little too much. I'm getting so geeky because there's so many little tweaks I want to make. This has too much resonance movement, in my opinion. There we go. And this one's too bright. Getting super geeky on y'all. Let's just get to the track. Y'all like, if y'all don't make this freaking track. Okay. Let me show you another chord technique. How many people do we have here? I'm smiling because that's my baby girl. She's excites me. What can I say? If your woman doesn't excite you, I don't know what to tell you. Not that you're going to be excited every single day if y'all have a problem or something, but I'm saying if your woman doesn't excite you, good luck. Okay, so we're going to go to stamps. And let's do a minor 11th chord, M11 for minor 11. Drag this out. Now the cool part about these chords is there's so many notes, you can do a lot of stuff with it. You can invert them. Let me go to the part where. Get the volumes right on him. Oh, shout out to Gilly Gill and his woman. It's a good girl right there. If she's sharing a moment with you like that, you got to respect that. You know how many couples get together and they don't even have common interests? Even if she doesn't necessarily like this channel, the fact that she's at least experiencing it with you is very rare. You got to realize that. You got to, finding somebody who's just willing to try stuff with you is very hard. So this cord is so dense that what I have to do is figure out what I even did to it. So we brought down this one. Oh. Then we need to convert this to a major. Oops. This chord sounds garbage. Let's do a sixth chord. This is another slept on chord type in R&B. It's a good passing chord. To shift, pull this up. And then this chord type is the wrong type, so we need to figure out what chord type it needs to be. So we did a minor 11th before, let's do a major 7. Do that. That sounds wrong to me. So we're gonna take the 3rd and 7th, pull it down one, make sure that top note's the same. This sound just feels so thin, it's bothering my soul. Sometimes if you turn up resonance too much, it thins it out. I'm trying to figure out why the sound feels so empty. Too popular. Okay, now let's put this on the layer. Thicken it up. I don't like that last chord. Let's invert the notes. There we go. So now the top note needs to be C. We're gonna cycle between either a minor 9 or a major 7, where the top note is C. No, Sasha's Fattener would make it too scratchy. It's something in the core sound itself, like it's not a very thick sound. Take out a couple notes here. I don't like that voicing. Let's pull it up an octave. I don't know what this last chord needs to be. It needs to be. Let's figure this out. We're going to keep hacking our way through it. The image line wavetable would be pretty cool. What envelope? Not familiar with. Forgive me, I don't know the context. I'm just not liking that last chord. So again, these chords that I heard in the song are not long. So here's a little shortcut for you. If you use FL, go to the top left, go to Edit, Discard Lengths, and it will make everything the same length. It needs like a at the end, but I can't wrap my head around what chord I would want. All right, so maybe I want a tritone chord. So notice I'm using my brain, but then I'm trying to figure out what chord goes with what my brain hears. Blue team, says Jubs. Now here I'm going to use fifths. I know I'm moving extremely fast and not explaining a thing. Fifth Stallion's too rocky, rock style. Not liking the ending, but whatever. Okay, so I'm gonna deviate from his exact, that exact song, because it has piano in it too, or like some kind of piano style bell. But at least I showed y'all the plugins. It's taking me a minute to get the exact sound I want. But something just sounds thin. Like these sounds feel thin to me. Let's open up another Diva and let's find a bell. I think I have this already made, so hopefully I can save some time. Do I have it pre-made? I swear I had presets in here. Into jazz. There's a key change. So we're going out into borrowed keys. Teaching this stuff is giving me it. I'm super frustrated because I explain everything. But what happens in jazz is they use borrowed chords that go outside the scale. So the scale that you could be playing 1 second, you could switch a scale mid chord progression. And now you're in a whole different scale. So I was going to say play this scale, but then it changed. It needs like a, it needs more harmonics. A tonic chord. I don't even know what key we're in. Maybe these are too low, that's why. Take back the brassy feeling to the DJ Ray. He actually has his account. Shout out to DJ Ray. I still don't like these chords, y'all. This is bothering me. I have so much cognitive dissonance right now over these chords. I think what I'm gonna do is so my theory is like once I have a max note, I don't go above that note. So in this case, B is that note. So I'm pulling anything above B down. It usually gives me the voicing that I want. Ascending keys is here, what's up? Oh dang, he's no computer gang. I want an exotic chord on the turnaround, I just can't remember. I'm just gonna use that chord. I don't even know what chord that is. I don't know, it's bothering me though. The last chord's bothering me. The whole sound design is bothering me because it's not the exact sound I want either. But I just, the problem here, let me explain it to y'all so I can get my frustration out. Shout out to everybody who's even here. The frustration in my head is I need to sound design it to get the exact sound I want. But the problem is, since we're live streaming, sound designing will be the most boring thing to watch me do. That's the conundrum that I'm facing in my head. So I'm like, how do I get the sound without taking 30 minutes to get the exact sound? That's the frustrating part. to add some detail to this. Let's add the LFO over the pitch. Trying to make it such a small amount that it's not noticeable. There you go. I forgot I had chorus on this too. I'll just make a track and just be like, Keyshawn, spit over this. Because I hate remaking people's tracks. Let's just start from scratch. My brain needs to destroy before we rebuild. I have to, or else I'm going to get so frustrated. So if you ever had this moment where you just delete everything, I freaking understand. I'm going to start with drums. Because I don't know why I got so pissed about that. I was legitimately angry in my head that I couldn't get the sound I wanted. So let's not do that. Let's do this. Let's just follow our gut. And let me think. We need clap alternatives, that's for sure. We need that. That pumpy clap. We need a tonal clap. Okay, so I like layering claps and building them up over time. This one's gonna be on the last ones or the second ones. So it's boom, clap. And then we're gonna layer that with the other clap. My overheating, my brain CPU was overheating. That friction was getting a little too heated. Okay, let's layer this one to thicken up the clap. But this one we're gonna delay with the time wrench. Okay, so now we have the claps. Now we can go back and add the hi-hats and the kicks. So the claps usually create the attitude for the track. Now let's go back and find the kicks and all the little percussion stuff. Now I'm gonna go back to that Amun's kit because he has really cool bouncy percussion that we can use to keep the track bouncy. So I'm gonna use these as like impact and bounce elements. So let's hit Control L, send these to the mixer. Close out the browser. Add pattern two, already a pattern two. Add this in. So now we're gonna use the deeper sound as the down pack impact. Drag this out to Control B. Then we're gonna use the lighter percussion to bounce. So I'm gonna draw it in. Usually I play it by hand, but we're gonna draw it in. Okay, so boom, tap, 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 tap. Now we're not gonna make it that bouncy. Just gonna repeat that pattern. Realize why I'm angry, y'all. Y'all ready? I didn't eat yet. That's why I'm angry. I'm hangry, y'all. I'm hangry. I destroyed my whole project because I'm hangry. Smash the like button if you can relate. If you never ate, but you can relate. Okay, this is more of a bouncy track we're gonna make for Keyshawn. Now that other, those other sounds just weren't full enough. Like watch when I play your grand piano, it's gonna sound more full. Now we don't live together. That'd be nice. Keyscape. Okay, let's play some nice chords. Oh, maybe because my headphones are down. That's why my headphone volume is down. Oh, Clayton, thanks for letting us know. So when to record that, I just play kind of a riff. But we are going out of key at certain points in the bass. I don't know, my sounds just don't feel like they sound full. I don't know if it's my ear or what. These sounds feel like hollow today. These don't feel full. Hold on, I messed up. So let's turn the metronome on. Ooh, wrong chord. So I messed up the one of these turnaround chords. This is the last one, I think it is. I don't know, I'm like hearing myself that loud either. Okie doke. I think I'm used to hearing my iPhone headphones because I was on those all last night, sound designing. So if you want a free analog pack, if you're just joining in and you have no idea what's going on, the Discord link is right here. It's busyworksbeats.com/discord. Then once you can join for free. There's an analog pack. I just made it and put it together for you. It's a celebration for us hitting 10,000 people in the Discord. So shout out to you guys. And I'm still here. It's just, I realized why I was so frustrated with it, with the last track. Okay. I don't have anything to eat. There's nothing to eat. Hold on. This needs to be done. So let's pull this up. Then this should be C, E, G. And we'll do A in here. Need a, these sounds aren't giving me what I want. So this sound needs to be more bitey. Like there's a sound from Roland's SRX piano, I think it's called. I think it's called like dance piano. Something, I forget where it's at. It's one of these though, I'm gonna find it. But it's like, burp, like when you hit the note, you hit the note. It sounds very full. Nature Valley. Y'all got snacks on deck. So I'll show you the MIDI in a second. Give me a second. So in the analog pack, I've included MIDI as well. In the pack, free. It's free. I need that. Which plugin has it? Oh, I forget which plugin it is. Is it the. Not this one. Dang, I'm trying to think. Is it Korg? Nah, wait. I know Nexus has one, but that's not the plugin I'm thinking of. Has a dun. So you need something that has that kind of expression to it. This just has a lot of bass in it. Let me turn on my headphones. Hold up. It's probably half the battle. This isn't the preset I wanted because it's a little more quiet. Keyshawn is how you spell it right there. On Instagram, his name is something way different. It's like, I don't even know how to spell it. He needs to change his Instagram name because it's too complicated. Makayako, I forgot how to spell it. Let me find out. It is, hold up. It's M-A-K-A-I-O. Makayo Music _. That's his at on Instagram. He just needs to make it Keyshawn, something like that. We know him as Keyshawn, not as the other name, so it's very hard to remember that name. But yeah, I'm making a track for him right now, and I'm gonna challenge the community to also do the same thing. And I'll have a better video explaining the whole process once we're down that pathway. Let me just get my mind around producing first. Also, I do have my synths plugged up. Just to show you. So you heard all the synthesizing stuff. Let's pull up line 5 and 6, and this should play my synth. Just to show you the difference in synth. Oh wait. Line 5 and 6 is not 5 and 6 here. Let's figure out what it is. All right. 5, 6. No, that's the mic. Hold on, y'all. This thing's routed weird because I've installed some software that screwed everything up. Okay. Why is this not reading 5 and 6? Oh, is it 5 and 6 on the other one? That might be it. Oh, that's why. It's on the other device. Okay, so 5 and 6 over here is, I don't even know where that's at. Give me a second to do some math. 5 and 6 is line 9 and 10. Which is somewhere, don't even know. Just click stuff till it works. Click inputs till it works. Wait, 7, 8. Where's 9 and 10? How does this work? Let's figure this out together. Okay, so line 5 and 6 is going to channel. Let be. I don't even know how this works, y'all. Not gonna waste time. Oh, it's B here. It's right there. How did I not see that? There we go. See how analog just has a actual full sound? So I don't have to actually go up to that keyboard to play those sounds. I can set up my MIDI controller with a MIDI out. And I just want to show you the difference in quality. So you heard how we were struggling to get that sound. It just felt super empty and super void. Now I can control my MIDI, my analog synth using MIDI. Just gonna turn it down a little bit. And then we're gonna plug in notes just like we did with the piano. Now I don't know why it's not triggering here. Why is it? It was just working 2 seconds ago. What happened? Okay. I don't know what just randomly stopped working. Let me set it up. Maybe I didn't set my MIDI up. Maybe I thought I did, but I didn't. Okay, output port 1, input. I literally just did it 2 seconds ago and y'all saw me do it. So I don't know what just happened. Okay, the input just randomly stopped. And the heezy is gone. Hold on, y'all, this thing is bugging. Big time. 5 and 6, line B, 5 and freaking 6. B, 5 and 6, what's the problem? I guess you have to have arm for record on. So I guess this doesn't. That is odd. Why does that need to be? Okay, so only when it's on record does it listen to the signal. That's interesting. Okay, so now I'm gonna mess with the actual keyboard. So y'all have been waiting this whole time. Finally, I pulled out the analog, but the problem was you couldn't see it, so it was pointless. So now you can hear the difference. Now you saw all that struggle we had with the synths, trying to get it to sound right. I'm gonna walk over to the analog synth and get it to sound right in like 2 seconds. And I'm just gonna turn off my webcam because I don't feel like being on cam. But you're gonna hear the difference in a second. Same exact MIDI. Chicken wing. First of all, look how full it is. I could turn off the other sounds. And just this alone fills up the whole track. Big Drew's here. Gotta make sure we're not clipping. See how it sounds better already? That's just one synthesizer. See the difference in the sound? Before, it took like 1,000 things to even like make one sound. When you get analog stuff, it just sounds good. That's why I said analog is, to me, is a lot better. This is at low volume as well. Hear the pitch variation in there? Let me turn it up a little bit. Even with the flaws in my playing, that sounds a lot more full than what we had before. Let me just, I deleted it because I was getting so frustrated about how far off it sounded. So let's play the Prophet 5 and compare it. Now, these are two different Prophets. One's a Prophet 6, one's a Prophet 5. That's what I mean. Like when you have an actual good sound, you're not fighting to make stuff sound good. That's like half the battle. It's like if you have a good recording, you don't have to mix a lot. It's the same thing with analog versus these digital plugins, even though they sample analog stuff according to them. I'm trying to find that sound we had. I forget which preset we used on that one. I mean, it's close, but when you hear those side by side, it's gonna be like, what was I buying? But I would recommend buying this stuff though, because again, very hard to afford this stuff. I think it was this one right here. Something like this. Okay, so let's copy the same exact notes and I'm gonna play these back to back just to show you why I got so frustrated. So let's do the synth first, then the analog. And where's the wait pattern? It's not playing. This on a new track. I even turn up the volume. gonna take off some of the pitch variation. Give me a sec. Not sure why it's pitch is wobbling like that, but has to be something. So my point is, in my ear, this just sounds more authentic. One is a stereo rise, that's another effect too. This one just feels like bum, 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 bum. The other one feels like wham, 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 wham. There's a lot more going on. But you can't get them close. Okay, so let's build this record that we've been trying to build for the last hour. And some of these notes are off, but I don't feel like fixing them. So we're gonna use the MIDI out to control the synth. Let's fix this rhythm. It's too stop and go-ish. So that's an analog sound for those who are wondering the difference. Hopefully you can hear the difference. In my ear, it's just more like life to the second sound. Take out that bongo. There we go. Okay, let's add some heavy drums like our kick and snare. Okay, let's find it. So boom, ka, boom, ka, boom. Some of these claps are a little loud. I'm gonna turn them down. I think it's just the MIDI notes I played are wrong. What I might do is convert this to audio. Yeah, because right there I hit a sour note. Hold on. Okay, so here's what I'm gonna do. You can't just right click and consolidate a track from track start when you're using MIDI out, because it's going to a real synthesizer and a real synthesizer plays real notes. So you have to record it into Edison. Go to Edison, let's open it up, record on play, hit record, hit stop twice. So this is called, I think some people call offline bouncing. It's when you don't have a computer algorithm to like go through the music and export it. You have to manually record it. Unison, you said when they sampled it, it was in unison. Could it be possible when they sampled it, it was in unison and the analog is in polyphonic mode? Could be, depends on how many voices and everything. So let's record the synth real quick, and then I'll turn it down. Right now it's too loud. Also, what I could do as we're recording, I'm gonna go over and mess with the filters real quick. But hear that difference? It's like night and day. So the second time around, I'm just gonna mess with the filters real quick. As we're recording, so it's recording the changes. This is the difference of analog and synth and digital. Now I'm gonna mess with the envelopes. So I did two runs of it. Now I didn't do the most expressive thing on the second time around, but it's all good. So I was just messing with the low pass filter to give it a different harmonic tone. So that's what you could do with analog stuff as you're playing it. You could turn stuff as you're doing stuff. It's called a Prophet 6. That's what I was using, by Dave Smith Instruments. So what we're gonna do is take the first one, double click, send to playlist as an audio clip. Double click the second song jump, send to playlist as an audio clip. So now you have two of the same thing, but they're different. So you could pan one hard left, one hard right if you wanted to, and then make it a thicker sound, or you could separate these into sections. So I'll do the first one, and we'll route these to the mixer, hit Control L. So now I have one that's filtered to the right, one that's brighter on the left side. So they kind of play off each other, the little small differences. Makes a nice full sound. I still think these are too long, so I'm going to group them together under chords. And now I think you can hit Control G. Yeah, you can highlight two audio clips, hit Control G to make it one. So now we can do cool stuff. This is an FL Studio 20.9 that I just did that. Now you can do cool stuff like reverse the audio. Oh no, the MIDI's still playing. Not feeling the reverse, but it's cool, but that's not my thing. Next thing we're gonna do is go to Mode, Stretch Mode Pro, and then stretch this out. So we're at 32 bars, let's go to time stretch mode and make this 64 bars. Okay, so now it's slowed down. Now what I'm gonna do is pitch this whole thing up 1200 cents and then change the formant. It's gonna change the tonality. Now we get a unique sound. Shout out to DJ Wraith. Forgive me for not reading everything. It's just too difficult to make beats and read everything at the same time. Shout out to you. So I like the first half, this part right here. I like these, I'm just gonna repeat those. Okay, so now I'm just gonna right click the hi-hat, so you can do fill each two or fill each four steps. Take out this is too bright. Let's add a mod X, which muffles the bongo. We're also gonna delay with time shift. So that's how you make your melodies unique, using audio, all those things I just showed you. think the hi-hats are too early. Let's go to the wrench tool, time shift. Okay, so now it just needs to be either a vocal or a bass to kind of fill it up. VCOs, Eric Synth VCOs. The DJ Wraith wanted me not to give out his secrets for his his style track. What did I just click on? Whatever I just clicked on, it just screwed something up. I don't even know what I just hit. What just happened? Something just glitched. That was random. Okay, so now let's find a bass. Now we could do atmospheric stuff like a flute. Let's start with this. Okay, so I'm gonna drone. Let's record this. Turn off my mic, it's still loud. And now I'm just gonna use monophonic mode so it doesn't overlap the notes of the bass. Your analog synth shows itself. No, this is I'm using a different synth. My analog is a Prophet 6, this is a Prophet 5. I didn't wanna focus too much on that because you can't see it, that's why. So let's put this on mono mode. Leave legato mode is the way to do it here. If that doesn't work, go to your voices and make sure it says one voice. Beat's a little slow. I'm adding resonance to make it more 90s R&B. It hollows out the sound a bit, so you have to balance resonance with not hollowing out the sound. Okay, so it just needs a compressor. Happy New Year's to you as well, appreciate you. I'm just so focused on this track because the other track I had to scrap it. So this one I have to make it work. Okay, so now we need vocals in my opinion before we start adding more stuff. So let's figure out what key we're in. How many people are even here? Shout out to everybody who suffered with me for that first hour because I was like about to throw this computer out. No, I wasn't, let me stop. But I was frustrated. So I scrapped the first beat we made. What is going on? And then I started all over again. The Able Kit, maybe on a different track. So now I need to do vocals. Let's figure out what key we're in real quick. Because the jazz chords, when I go out of key, it's hard to articulate. We're in A natural minor. So what I'm gonna do is try one thing. We pulled this up an octave, but let me pull it down a step so it's gonna lower the key down one. So now we're in, what is this? We're in G sharp minor. I like that tone. Let me pull it down 100 cents more. So now we're in G minor, which is a more common key. Yeah, I like this better. Then let's hit shift down on our MIDI. 2, 1, 2. Now the bass should match. This might be too low. It's so low that you can barely hear the notes. Okay, but now we're in G minor. So the drums need a little more activity. But before we get there, let's set up a reverb and then let's set up a vocal so we can get this idea out. So we're in G minor. We just need to set up a reverb. What reverb do we want? Dream, let's use a real verb. Where is it at? Real verb. Real verb. Okay, so let's switch mics real quick. One sec, I'm trying to find a preset. I just forgot what I called it. Hold up, what did I call this thing? Did I forget to save it? Wait, vocal. Darn, I think I forgot to save it. This might be it right here, I think. No, that's not it. What was my chain name? Darn, I forgot to save it. Thought I saved it. That was okay. So I didn't save it. Or no, here it is. Why would I name it this? It's the worst name. Okay, so I found it. Never mind. And Tiller-esque. Okay.
Tide is playing, thunder, love rain, it's just rain, it's just the way I do. Still, and what you used to, and this ain't what you used to. The things you do, it's by the thing that don't ain't it. It's just the things you do.
Alright, add the on-tune speed too slow. Crank it up. Crank it up. Crank it up, turbo. Crank it, turbo. Hey, turbo, crank that. Crank that, turbo.
Tired explaining it.
Wow, it's so much louder. The freak. Why is that so much louder? Explain to me why that's so much louder.
Tired.
What in the freak? Hold up. Why is it so much louder?
That was like 1,000 times louder. I'm trying to figure out why.
Can't figure it out. My brain can't.
Tired explaining it. Don't ain't it. Tired explaining it. Don't ain't it. Love for rain. It's just for rain. It's just the way I do.
Idiot. Guess what? I was singing in G minor and the thing was on D minor the whole time. For real. Why was I singing out of key the whole time?
Tides playing it, don't ain't it, love rain, it's just rain, it's just the way I do.
Thank you.
outside on it. Even though the outside on it, it's just the way that outside on it, yo.
That harmony's not always that, but it's all.
All right, so we have two melodies. I'm gonna move to the next track, give me a sec. All right. But that's how we're gonna make the analog stuff sound modern. We're gonna time stretch it and do what we do. Okay, let's pan this out and then we need to copy that vocal chain. Give me a second to do all this. 24 and 25. So let's put these on 24 and 25. Hit Control L, send these to the mixer. These didn't go to 24 and 25, so we're gonna manually do it. Then pan one left, one right, just for stereo effect. I tried to match, but I... Now, if you want the Party Next Door sound, you go to your waves tune, and then there's a vibrato button somewhere. Where is it at? Here it is, vibrato. You can turn it on. Let me solo it real quick. I think they have a delay feature in here too. I might be wrong. Give me a second to look around. Time is this? That's tolerance time. Where's vibrato time? Maybe they don't have a vibrato time. But here's the amount of vibrato. I'm gonna exaggerate so you can hear it.
But you tell me on the outside. You don't really want it your side.
Can barely hear it. Hold on, crank it up.
But you tell me on the outside. You don't really want it your side. But it's reasonable.
It's kinda hard to hear it actually. Never mind. It used to be different in the autotune. But this isn't autotune.
But you tell me on the outside. You don't let it on your side. But it's made on your side.
So it's okay to have the pitch going. So because with the two vocals, you can't really tell that it's going out of pitch like that.
But you tell me on the outside.
You're wobbling.
You don't let it on your side. But it's made on your side.
So like I should have done it like that. Is that a vocal bender to the other vocal on the right? You could blend them. Let's add vocal bendings to both. Let's see what it sounds like. Now he sounds like he loves cake. So it goes with that slowed down effect. But you could blend it. Hold on. So now it sounds like we have four voices. Make the drums match that now. The bass is moving too much. The kick's too bouncy. Tweaking little things to make it feel like it's all slowed down. Pitching down the hi-hats.
Running down the outside on it. Even on the outside on it. It's just the
delay the kick. So now we're wrapping everything around the vocals. So this bass is moving too much. So I might just redo the bass to draw on the notes. Now that we have the vocals, we can go back. This is why I said vocals are an important part. So if you don't do vocals, at least hum it in your head to start realizing how much stuff needs to be changed. So now I'm gonna go boom, boom, boom. Where's our bass? Let's pull this up an octave so I can hear. Control up. And just hold the notes. That's the key to the sound. Let me find the bass. Why these synths are so quiet? Just hold that note. Make sure the notes overlap. Wait, why was that super offbeat? Well, mic is the one you use to record. It's a very expensive mic. It's called a Neumann U87, but it has a Chaotica eyeball around it. That's why it's not as bright. Chaotica eyeball. But the thing is, I'm in a very reverb. Like, you can hear the stuff off the walls. It's not treated at all. So it could be better treatment down here to get a better recording. I don't feel like spending a gazillion dollars. I just move out of a studio. We're doing that much recording down here anyway. Oh, I know why, because the notes. I don't know why this is not doing what it's supposed to sound like, but. Figure out this thing. Hold up. It's on legato, maybe that's why. I don't know, that thing is a little slow with the speed, the glide speed. It just sounds wrong. So I don't know why that's acting like that. Let me see something real quick. No. I don't know, this doesn't sound the way I want it to sound. It's a small detail, but whatever. Then just hold that note. So now the bass is a little more simple than what it was before. It was too bouncy before. Then we could hit control down. Even this is kind of high up. I might change the bass. If I like the sound, but I might change the bass. And change out the reverb. Actually, never mind on that. Just want a longer tail reverb. Just gotta figure out how to make this longer. That's a long reverb. I don't think the kick matches, but.
But you can't hold it outside.
Okay, so I'm gonna make another track. Also, I want to run it through a couple of processes. Not that this is mixing at all. So I need ear tickly stuff. Before we hop into the next track, let me just make sure I covered all my bases. It could use a little more delay, but again, be here all day trying to sound design Fruity Delay 3. It just needs like a little quick like flutter delay. So that's the vibe. Just gonna add two more plugins just to thicken it up real quick. Maybe it needs a little guitar. I want to plug up my electric. But I would have to take out the quarter inch cable. I could record acoustic. So I would record guitar with that. I might do that later. What's up? Yeah, sometimes the notifications don't go out. Even if you have the bell on, they just don't go out. Start a new track. My fault. Okay, so I'm gonna let you vote on which track we make this time, but we're gonna use Analog Technique. I'm not gonna use all Analog because Analog got me frustrated last time. Analog beat, but you get to choose the beat style. Yeah, I gotta edit that last one a little bit more. I'm gonna save it as a melody to send off. But what was I gonna say? Oh, the style. So which style track I wanna make? We got trap, aka tarp. We got trap beats. We got pop stuff. More R&B, kind of like what we just did. Then we got, what else is there? That nothing else exists. Trap, pop, and boom bap. Let you guys vote. Shout out to everybody for hopping in here. Forgive me for not reading the chat as much. I get distracted heavily when I'm producing and I read the chat. It just screws me up sometimes. Move this over here. Hold on 1 sec. Hip hop, Nafi Beats style, Nafi Beats. Show you his whole chain. I'm just playing. Supposed to be making R&B beats for these artists, but I got off track. I'm gonna do like a, but I need to make it more clear like how it works. But I'll do that a different day. Monte Booker's beats are hard. Funk. I saw, was it Ed Talanti? He did the funk. Took his attempt at funk. I don't listen to it enough to even know what the heck funk is. Some Bay Area type beats. Lo-fi night, hip hop. I guess hip hop's so broad. So trap, but what type of trap? There's Bay Area, which is like, not really trap, is it? I guess it's trap. Trap is kind of a blurry genre now. Yeah, people want to know my style, but my style is, they would get lost very quick because I use a lot of keyboard. I use a lot of this stuff behind me. And if I start going down that path, it's just a lot of recording that nobody, it's not entertaining to watch somebody record. Just hit record. It's just not that entertaining. Trip hop. Some taco Thursdays. What's today? Is today Thursday or am I making that up? Taco Thursday. Nafi Beats type beat. They want the formula, Nafi. Rolling cowbell as the synth. Oh, the funk. Trap is definitely on board. Maybe we could do, oh, you know what? I forgot. Nicole put me on to, his name is Blast. People keep asking me about Blast, but his stuff is like guitar based too. I would have to get my guitar to play something. But I haven't played guitar in so long. I would have to plug up, or what I could do. Actually, I might not have to do all that. Let me see if there's a delay. Yeah, it's not. But the holidays are for businesses to make money. Once you become a business and you realize the holidays are literally just set up to make businesses money, you stop being on the consumer side of things. You want to make money on those holidays. You don't want to spend money. You want to get money. That's why I said I'm not focused on partying. Rather get money than go party. Timbaland. Plus, I mean, the world is not in a good state to be out around people anyway. All right, so trap is the heavy vote. I'm just looking at the subgenres of trap that you want, though. Blast. Blastoise mixtape. So I'm gonna have to get my electric guitar and then plug it up over her. I'm trying to think of an easy way to do this without rearranging my whole patch bay. Give me a second to think. I guess I gotta start with the guitar, that's the only thing. Okay, so let's tap it out. Probably gonna be around 150-ish BPM. Real quick, I just have to turn off my webcam because I have to set up the guitar. So I'm gonna play a little background music as we wait. And let's go here. Okay, so I'm gonna play a little interlude music as we. Our apologies, as we set this up.
hop in a Benz in the new body. Then I pull up with my friends in a Bugatti. Got a rolling on a wrist in a new ride. And I'm rolling with the team. Higher than Pluto, we out of space. Running the game, we first place. Stacking the blue, no speaking paid. And we about to blow up like grenade. All I know is getting this money. Funny as it used to call me bummy. Now I'm just crazy like a tsunami. And I'm rolling with the team. Higher than Pluto, we out of space. Running the game, and we in first place. Stacking the blue, no speaking paid. And we about to blow up like grenade.
Yeah, everybody got a body, ain't nobody got a witness. I've been riding shoddy probably since Nick was a kid. But I'm running rap games like a nigga running fitness. Double gear on my denim cause a nigga got a hit list. All I do is want bags on my gift list for Christmas. I got green like a Grinch, all they do is smoke stench. I'm a player, you get benched. I'm my nigga, that's the bench.
I'm amazing, got the car in the keys, bitch, I'm racing. Got the car in the keys, bitch, I'm blazing. I'm amazing. I'm amazing.
All right, my bad. I'm trying to figure out why my high Z input is not working. I think I have a broken preamp, which is whack. So I'm playing the note. This should be lighting up this channel right here, but it's not. So I don't know what the issue is here. Oh, I have a broken interface. Great. Okay. That's why I don't plug up the guitar. If I do two, I'm trying to think, y'all. Give me a sec. Two goes to this. Three. Try one more thing, but if that doesn't work, then scrapping the electric. Give me a sec, y'all.
Jumping in this bitch, yeah, yeah. Wait, I should have been coming off the bench. What it should have been, jumping in this. Yeah, wait, I should've been popping up the dots. Yeah, the dots, man, they should've been. Wait, should've been jumping in this bitch. I said okay, wait. I done been jumping in this bitch. I said okay with it. We done been jumping in this bitch. I said okay, then we should've been jumping in this bitch.
MTV, we in your crib.
Mask off with the mask.
Like
off.
Harry Potter, keep that stick.
Blast off, they just blast off.
You know
off.
They raising up the bleed.
You know that they getting hit.
You know they ready. Like it,
all they do is set and break.
But I keep you whack, you like the hit.
Boy, you whack it in some shit.
Boy, I'm in that back, y'all keep them hits.
But you know I am legit.
And the diamonds dancing, they like tea.
Man, it's tic tac on my ring.
But I'm on that road just like a dude.
You get dirt, just then swear it.
Busy.
So basically, you wanna live, but I can take that. So basically.
Check. So we have to do a little temporary workaround because the way my bank account is set up, now the way my Patch Bay is set up, this thing is all over the place. So the way the Patch Bay is set up makes it extremely difficult to just plug up my electric guitar and just play. I have to do all this other stuff. Why didn't I think to plug it up in the other HZ? Duh. My brain didn't even think. Give me, actually, I have a better solution. So give me 2 more minutes to test it, and then we'll get to this beat. My fault. I didn't even think about my other interface. That way we don't have to sacrifice my microphone when we play.
Busy.
One, there we go. Why didn't I think of that before? You guys will know the struggle when you get your own patch bays and stuff. Very convoluted. Let's lock this. Just gotta turn it on, analog one. Work. And this should be B line one. Where's it at? Where is it? I don't see it.
I hop in a Benz in the new body. Then I pull up with my friends in a Bugatti. Got a Rolly on a wrist and a new ride. And I'm rolling with the team. Higher than Pluto, we out of space. Running the game, we first place. Stacking the blue, no speaking pay.
And we about to blow up like grenade.
All I know is getting this money. Funny as this used to call me bummy. Now I'm just crazy like a tsunami. And I'm rolling with the team. Higher than Pluto, we out of space. Running the game and we in first place. Stacking the blue, no speaking pay. And we about to blow up like grenade.
Yeah, everybody got a witness. I've been riding shoddy probably since Nick.
Might have to restart FL so it recognizes. This is my only guess. Give me a sec. Oh, wait. Man, signal routing is a whole different headache. Okay, now we are good to rock. Got the guitar plugged up. I got my mic set up. Cool. We're just down 1/4-inch cable, but it's all good because we're not using the synth anyway. So you, I know you heard that glaring sound. That's because the volume's up too loud. The gain is up too much. And yes. Boom. Okay. I'm telling y'all, when you get patch bays and have to do signal routing and all that type of stuff, it is a whole different thing. Sorry, I lost a lot of folks on that. That was mandatory maintenance. Okay. Now we're ready to rock. I forgot what we're even doing. What track were we doing? A blast track? So I'm going to mess around with some guitar stuff. We're going to go to 150 BPM. I think we were at 150. 150 blast. Now, I didn't hear his whole style. I just heard like a guitar track that was kind of like Roddy Ricch, but more guitar and melodic. So the first step is, to tune your guitar. So with synths, you don't usually have to do this, but with real instruments, they can go out of tune. So that's the first step, is tune your guitar so that when you're playing the B note, it actually sounds like the B note and not the F note. Okay, so now I'm not a guitar player by any means. I don't know any chords off the top of my head. What I usually do is reverse engineer the tone of chords and then I'll just put my fingers in position to play it. So I'll go, okay, I like that tone. Then I'll go, oh, you can't even hear this. Hold up. I'll say, I like this tone. Then I'll say, I need this tone. And then I'll just add them all together. That sounds cheesy, but. Shout out to the funk guitar players who can play that groove guitar. I don't know how you guys do that. You said I've been in a couple of pro studios. I know the drill a little bit. convoluted that game. It's just, it's a whole different thing. Can't just load up a plugin and be good. It could take 30 minutes just to get stuff set up sometimes. Okay, without further ado, we are at 150 BPM. We need to figure out a nice chord. Now I'm gonna run this guitar through an amp so we get a vibe. So it's not just dry guitar. Let's run it through amplitude. Where are you at? Amplitude, vibe. You could also run it through Guitar Rig for a vibe. I'm gonna use amplitude. Whoa. And they can really hear the high frequency. Okay, so let's get rid of that high frequency because it's super, super annoying. So let's do EQ2, and it's a very specific high frequency. So let's do a notch filter and then sharpen it up so it's super tight, and then just until we go over that frequency, it's bothering us. And now it's going. You kind of hear it a little bit. But if I take it off, hear that tone? So something in this electricity is making it do that high frequency. I have one, two, I have a bass guitar, I have an Epiphone for like country guitar, I have a Squire Stratocaster, and I have an acoustic guitar, and then I have a ukulele, which I have behind me. I used to play, I need to like really get into guitar, because that's the sound of right now is the guitar. Okay, so let's figure out some chords. I'm just gonna mess around until we figure out something. There's no rhyme or reason to this. I don't know how to teach guitar, so there's nothing I can tell you. This is a real guitar. Real guitar, over here, boy. Play a real guitar. Still a novice on the guitar. Might make a Nafi type beat. I mean, I don't know if that's a blast style. Let me see if that's. Let's start with that, because that sounds cool. I like that. Let's go to song mode, let's record. Gonna come out like a Dr. Dre track. So I'm doing palm mutes. And I'm doing the top and bottom string. I forgot it was on loop record. Hold up. Let's delete those because they eat up space. Delete, delete. So I'm playing E at the top string and E at the bottom string. It's palm muting and then playing with my finger. Kind of striking it with my, like flicking it. I'm gonna have all these terms down by next year when I learn guitar, watch. Okay, so I did that many because I want variation. I don't want the same thing all the way through. That's why a lot of beats sound stale. Let's hear this. A little delayed. Let's see what we can add over top of that. I'm trying to think, what chord could I do? Like. It's had little tickles. You see, I'm so scientific with it. Little tickles. I'd so much like buying an electric and learning. It's a dedication though. It's not like a, it takes a long time. Well, I can't say a long time, but it takes a lot of practice. I don't practice that much. So I'm just gonna add this little tickle time. Here we go. Let me get my, so we're playing half steps. So I didn't even let the hammer on like strike the second note. It's supposed to go dun, but I accidentally cut it off at dun sometimes where it just goes up, wink. So we're gonna pick this up with effects. We're just not there yet. So, rolling with it, lean, and you own that. So now we need some kind of melodic thing going on in the in-betweens. So again, I'm just adding little stuff. It probably would have been better if I started with chords, not this dissonant half step. So again, it probably would have been better if I started with chords. Again, I wish I knew chords off the top of my head. I have to sound it out though on the guitar. I'm not a player like that. Play with your teeth? He played the guitar with his teeth? No, he didn't. I don't believe that. There's no way he played it with his actual teeth. Hilarious. I'm reading Clayton's line. So now let's figure out a chord. I wanted to go. Let me just figure out the notes first. So I wanted to go. So, or wait. Hold on, I'm trying to get my fingers right. That might be amplitude doing that. I forgot that it goes through an amp by default. I was wondering why it sounded like that. My bad, it was going through an amp the whole time. This is what it sounds like. I knew there was something weird about it. Only chord I could think of, this chord. It's not even that lush sounding. Maybe I'll do like a little funk. We're gonna do two takes. Oh, I did a loop. My bad. I thought I had it on a loop recording. Let's put on loop recording from now on. Do the same. Freak. Oh, I didn't have my pick in hand. Darn it. Hold up. Chords could be better. Again, I wish I knew chords. Okay, so we're gonna pan one left, one right. So the whole left-right trick is more than just a stereo spread. It also gets rid of flaw. So let's hit Control L. So now it's harder to hear the flaw. So now it sounds wide. So now it just needs like one more thing. So this might turn into a West Coast track. Forget Blast, I guess. Tupac playing the guitar. So now I'm just gonna add a little melodic background stuff. Just stuff around. Come on, man. My fingers, darn, man. I don't have fingernails. Here we go. Okay. So adding those two up, again, you pan one left, one right, creates that stereo effect, and it creates, wait, that's the wrong track, hold on. Wait, hold up, 4 and 6, how's that? I might redo the bass. Oh, hold on. Just thicken it up. Wait. It sounds so much different. So I'm going to do this separately because I want to stereoize the bass. Palm mute. Some stuff I did a full palm mute, some stuff I didn't. You don't know what all that means, it's all good. That's why I said recording doesn't look as exciting as making a beat on the screen. So I'm just recording all the parts so I can stereoize all this stuff. I'm gonna pan one left, one right. So now it feels like it's like a built-in micro shift. Let's pan it out. Why is it? Make a Nas beat on this. Okay, so I need to do the top string. So I'm gonna do hammer-ons instead of dun, 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 dun. It's gonna be this. I don't know if y'all can hear that. So it goes dun. So I'm gonna do that instead and layer that up. I forgot how the rhythm went. Oh, wait. Wait. Okay, my bad. Screwed up the rhythm. Okay, let's do this 2 times and then we'll get to the beat, like the drums and stuff. So that I did like a pitch fall effect. So it goes bam, then it goes down. So I created a small difference is the point in the left and the right ear. So we're gonna hit Control L. So without any plugins, just doing two takes and then panning one left, one right. So I think we have a full, probably too much stuff going on. Okay, so let's figure out what we want and what we're gonna cut out. Okay, so now we can work around this. Now it's not the most musical R&B sound, more of like a West Coast Dr. Dre type of sound. Naffy Beats type of sound, should I say? Now we need the aggressive piano. So you could do, if you don't have all these plugins, there's a plugin called FL Keys, and you could put it on presets, dance piano, and then you could play really low octaves. I take that stompy sound. So I'm playing the note D. Just playing fifths, D and A. So I like the lower octaves. So. I'm just gonna play those notes, which is A flat. Okay, so it's D, A, and then D up an octave. I mean, no. No, it's A up an octave. So how did I just play? Now I forgot what I played. Crap. It was D, A. Oh, I forgot what I just played, y'all. Okay, it was D, and then an octave of D, and then A. That's what it was. Then it's A flat. I mean, excuse me, B flat. To create that contrast. One, two. Play too hard. We can mess with the velocity later. Then let's do a change up. Let's do B flat again, just on the change up. Messed up the notes. Just trying to go. So that's FL Keys. It actually has a decent sound to it. Let's hit Alt Q. Now, this velocity structure is way too heavy, so we need to hit Alt X, pull this down. Or you could add a compressor to the piano, that could also do the job. So we need some kind of like, I mean, it could be vibey, I mean, not vibey, but it could be like atmospheric like this, but I want some kind of musicality to come in somewhere. And the only thing is I don't have a pitch effect that I could use. So I'm trying to think for a second. So what they used to do with like, to find a preset, what they used to do with like triangles, for example, I think I have one. Like these, they would pitch it up. They would play a chord and pitch the chord up. So they would play, what would you play? D minor. But they would pitch it up, so you can't hear what I'm doing. Let's crank this up an octave so you can really hear. So if I play a chord, that's the West Coast sound. They pitch up their chords as they play. So I'm gonna add a compressor to this piano real quick. Let's tame it down a little bit. Who else showing you how to make trap beats like this? What's up? Say octaves on the piano? Yeah, D. Oh, here's the notes. My bad. D is an octave. So it's the same note, just up an octave, it's called. 12 notes up. So we're playing the octaves of D and then the fifth of D, which is an A on top. That's the top note. So we're really not playing a chord, it's more like a power chord, if anything. So we want to take this darkness and make it somewhat West Coast, but what they do with the West Coast is they pitch bend their chords. It's like I just did it. So what I'm going to do, I know this is all over the place, we're going to restrain the pitch range to 6 so I can hear that. So I can do a full pitch bend and it won't like go out of key. So that's the little stuff that we're adding. What's up, Chirac? So I'm just adding little stuff. So this beat's a little, if you go high pitch like I just did, you might have to do slower pitch bend. So I'm just gonna mess around with these and then we'll change out the sound. That didn't match right there. It was hit or miss, but usually it's with a triangle wave. 8 earrings. I don't know how they play 4 note chords. How do they? A nursery rhyme. Y'all got jokes today. Okay, so let's start adding these drums. I'm gonna play this by hand. Actually, I don't know if that's beneficial. I'm just gonna quantize it later. Let's record this. Add a rim. One of the snares didn't register for something. For what? For each side on what? Now the chords are, they're not necessarily playing the right chord, but it sounds right though. Some of these guitars need to be tuned down though. Pulled down, they're just too loud. I forgot all these are routed to 23 still. Let's send them out. Okay, so I like the snare placement. See if we can find a kick. I might just leave it unquantized, but let's see. Depends on if it sounds sloppy. I don't even know what kind of kick. I I don't even know what kind of pack. Not really vibing with that kick, but let's just see. Because we didn't add the hi-hats. If we are going to add any, we didn't add any yet. I don't know. Slower didn't fit. Maybe it doesn't need kicks. Maybe it just needs bass. Sometimes tracks don't need kicks. Yeah, it needs an 808. Doesn't need a kick. Let's get this music out. Let's group all this together. Hold up. Hit right click G to group, and then you can just hit the collapse button so it doesn't eat up your entire screen. What else could we add to this? Some Able Beat sound effects. He has those weird sound effects. I feel like we need, I know what we need. I'm trying to find his sound effects. Tonally dense, but we need to add this little wow 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 wow. It needs low end, but I don't know if it needs a kick per se. Oh, I just screwed up everything. What were we at, 145? No, we were at 150. What I'm gonna do is go to Tools, Macro, switch all audio clips to real time stretch. So now when I change the BPM, it doesn't go off beat. I think it just needs more BPM too.
With the tapers and now they with the tapers for Mark Jacob and
yeah, we need it more.
But I'm still here though.
So I'm just adding transitions to the beat. Yeah, this just needs heavy bass. I'm gonna quantize these snares. So we're gonna put trap drums over this. Let me see if quantizing screws it up or not. Let me see. I'm gonna write bars to this too. And I got bars. Okay. I need something to. Oh, that's what I want. We need, like, we need a choir to go. Let's find that sound. Human voices. Ooh. Is there a jazz voice? Maybe there's a jazz voice in here. We need. Ooh. Is there no oohs? Only doos? We need something like that, but not doos though. Where's our ooze? Where's the ooze at when you need them? We're gonna figure this out. Whoa. Now we need ooze. Where's the ooze? There has to be ooze up in here. Where the ooze at? Where the ooze? This might be a hook. Chop the vocal. I like those better than the ones. Like, this is too creepy sounding. It's like Halo, but maybe it is the dudes. Maybe it's this one. Let's just do that. On the turnaround. I know I'm all over the place, just adding a little detail. Wait. Wait. There we go. Do 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 do. Screwed up the thing again, man. There we go. I don't know if I like that part, but it is what it is. Alt Q. Guarantee. I don't know if I like that. That's not what I had in my head. Let me just do it like the way I hear it in my head. Hold on. It needs to be around the turnaround. Okay, it's a little something right at the turnaround. Nothing crazy. Doo doo da bop beady. Okay, so for the whole beat, we don't want the whole guitar track playing again. So what we're going to do is copy all this over. Hit shift, left click, drag it over. This time we're gonna get rid of the majority of the guitar because we don't want the guitar eating up the track. I forgot to do another guitar run. These little funk guitars, it's supposed to be dun, 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 and I forgot to do it. I forgot to record that. That's why it's half baked. Whoops. So now with all those, without the rhythm, there's no hi-hat to fill in that space. So the rhythm guitar is the hi-hat. Let's take out this dark piano. So now it's very void without those main events happening. Now we need the hi-hats to kind of fill in those gaps. Not kinda, we need those. And let's find the hi-hats. And let's get them G'd up. And I got the thing down. So now we're doing trap drums. Record this. So let me just pitch this. Hold on. So I'm just gonna play one. I didn't hit the background. Add a little time shift to your hi-hats, not too much. Let's pull this 808 down. Now I'm gonna record vocal. Gotta figure out what key we're in. I don't even know what key we're in. Then we're gonna add that little lasery sounds. Give me a sec. What key are we in? I don't even know. Minor, I think. We are in A. No, we're not in A minor. D minor. So now I'm just gonna sound like in my head. I hear a Pablo. I forget his name. Shorty. What's his name? Shorty. Yeah. Whatever his name is. I think it's Short D with the D-I-E. Yeah. So let me just kind of get that out of my head.
Usually deactivating plugins helps.
Usually I'm bombing and I'm being honest. For no dinner, no honesty, honesty. Usually the bonus and I need for the back. I've been hit the harness and I'ma be the back. Fucking hit the harness and I'ma be the G.
I'm referencing a very specific artist. If you don't know, it's all good.
Doesn't Thomas, you know they in the background. Yeah, we got an army, you know we legit. More presents on the army, you know the energy. We're facing you the army, you know we got that background. I didn't hit the Thomas, you know we in the background. Basically on Thomas, you know that I need it. That's the army, you know that that we is. We got an army, you know they in the back, girl. Yeah, we does it, Thomas, you know they in the back, girl. Then we got an army, you know they legit. For president of the army, you know that I'm the shit. For president of the army, you know we got the back, girl. I didn't get the Thomas, you know we in the back, girl. Basically, I'm Thomas, you know that I'm the shit. President of the army, you know that I'm the shit. We got an army, you know they in the back. Yeah, we does it, Thomas, you know they in the back. Yeah, we got an army, you know they legit. Cousin of the army, you know that I'm the shit. That I'm the shit. Cousin of the army, you know he got the back. Daddy of the Thomas, you know he in the back.
Shorty, not just shorty, it's shorty. I do like his style though.
Oh, Pablo, money can't see me dwelling. Oh, Pablo.
That guy. That's the guy I'm referencing. So I need to pan one left, one kind of right. Let's get this panned out. Figure out what's what. Hold up. It is a giant chaotic eyeball. Oh, you! I see what you mean, because this thing is, this piece and the other piece probably looks like one thing that makes it even funnier. Send this to the mixer. Pan one, kind of left, kind of right, because they're kind of the same.
But we got an army, you know they in the back. Yeah, we just in Thomas, you know they in the back. Yeah, we got an army, you know they legit. President of the army, you know that I'm the shit. For president of the army, you know he got the back. I didn't get the Thomas, you know he in the back. President of the army, you know that I'm the shit. President of the army, you know that I'm the shit.
Okay. Now we need to.
But we got an army, you know he in the back.
Check. We need to put the little tweaks to it, and we need to add a little lasery sound from the West Coast. So it's from Native Instruments battery pack, was it four? And it is called Zap Bro, but I called it Zap Bay for the Bay Area, Just gonna add this in. You could just play it by hand. There's no rhyme or reason to it. Usually it's on the bounce, so it's one, two, like that. I'm gonna start turning stuff down. Some of this stuff is loud. Where's my mic here? Yeah, that's why I'm making these. I'm actually sending these out, these melodies and stuff.
the power of adding the vocals to the track. Now you know how to rap stuff around the vocals, not just rap. There's no kick. What are you talking about? Maybe you're hearing this, thinking it's a kick because that's low frequencies. Where's the kick? I mean, where's the zap? That is one thing I forgot to do. The zaps have low frequencies in it. That I forgot to EQ that out. Just reminded me. But you want just enough. Because without the low end, it doesn't sound like a zap. So that's a tricky sound. So I use Pro Tools. I have it, but I don't use it as much as I probably should. Yeah, the kick just... I realized this like 6 months ago. Some beats just don't need kicks. How long have we been streaming? Because I have to call my baby girl eventually. Might take a little break. So this track is pretty done. This the audio real quick. Okay, then we need to print the other track that we did. I forgot what we did. What was the other track called? I forget. Is it this one? We only made 2 tracks. Thought we made 3. Why do I sound like that?
Thank you.
print this to audio. All right, well, this mic sounds so much louder now. But now we're gonna play these finished tracks and then we'll wrap this live. But I appreciate everybody for even hanging in this long. Let me start up a new thing.
Check. I forgot what the other track was called. Freak. I lost it. Gil says, hey, all, thank you for hanging and allow me to hang. But I really got to get going. Girlfriends wants to watch a movie. But love and busy work stay you, bro. Thank you, Gilly Gil. What y'all watching? Let the alligator loose. That's going to be our call for everything. Make sure you let the alligator loose. 10-4. Okay, let's open these up, see what they sound like. Then I'll wrap this live. If you guys only knew what Shorty, who that was. Go look up the song Pablo by Shorty. So I'm gonna wrap this live. I may go live later from Superboard, but I think that's enough live for today. Maybe not. Maybe it won't be enough live for today. Thank you all for hopping in. Thank you for staying this long. And until next time, peace.